discuss the constitutional provisions for the benefit of women and explain how it safeguards the interest and right of women. Discuss with case law in under preamble, right of equality, special provisions and directive principles. India's constitution contains several provisions aimed at safeguarding the interest and rights of women, reflecting the commitment to gender equality and justice. Let's discuss each category along with the relevant case laws. The introduction. The Indian constitution is committed to upholding the rights and interest of all citizens, including women. Through its various provisions, it seeks to ensure gender equality, dignity and justice for women across the country. These provisions are not only enshrined in the fundamental rights, but also in the directory principles of the state policy, making them fundamental to the governance and legal framework of India. Constitutional provisions for the benefit of women. Under preamble, the preamble of the Indian Constitution sets the foundational values of justice, equality and liberty, which are essential for safeguarding the rights and interests of women. While it does not explicitly mention women, it provides the overarching principles that guide the rest of the Constitution in ensuring gender equality. Right to equality, Articles 14 to 18. Articles 14 to 18 guarantee various aspects of equality before the law and equal protection of law. Article 15 specifically prohibits discrimination on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, or place of birth, thereby safeguarding women from discriminatory practices. Special provisions, Article 15(3), 39A, and Article 42. Article 15(3) empowers the state to make special provisions for women and children, ensuring their protection and welfare. Article 39A and Article 42 direct the state to ensure adequate means of livelihood and just and human conditions of work, including maternity relief for women. Directive principles of state policy. Article 39, Article 42, Article 44. Article 39 emphasizes the state's responsibility to ensure equal rights to men and women, particularly regarding livelihood and resources. Article 42 directs the state to provide maternity relief and human condition for work of women. Article 44 encourages the state to work towards a uniform civil code promoting gender justice. Case study. In the case of Visakha versus State of Rajasthan 1997, the Supreme Court of India addressed the issue of sexual harassment of women in the workplace. In the absence of specific legislation, the court laid down guidelines to prevent and address sexual harassment, invoking the constitutional principles of equality, dignity, and the right to work in a safe environment. This case highlighted the judiciary's role in interpreting constitutional provision to safeguard the interest and right of women, particularly in addressing emerging issues and gaps in legislation. Conclusion. The Indian Constitution lays a strong foundation for the protection and promotion of women's rights and interests. Through its various provisions, it seeks to ensure gender equality, non-discrimination, and the empowerment of women across all spheres of life. The judiciary, through its interpretation and ruling, plays a crucial role in upholding this constitutional principle and addressing challenges faced by women in society. However, continual efforts are needed to bridge the gap between constitutional ideals and their effective implementation, ensuring a more inclusive and equitable society for women in India.